crowd this morning. Good morning. The Bears' second season opens today, the one without Jim McMahon. The coach is counting on Mike Tomczak to do the job against the Steelers at Soldier Field today. And Jeannie's out in the audience. She's going to get all your questions. And Mike's special guest is defensive back Sean Gale, who made the big punt block last Sunday. And Mike, kind of the way I put it a minute ago, the second season, do you feel like with the McMahon situation resolved that maybe it is a kind of a second season for you?
Well, I don't think it's the second season, John. I just think it's a continuation, but I think it's in a different phase, really. Mm-hmm. And I don't really think that we're depending on Mike Tomczak to do the whole job out there. We've got a pretty good surrounding cast of characters out there, the defense and the offensive line and the receivers, special teams. So we're going to give Mike and Steve and Doug all the help we can and hope that we can put seven more away and get out of this thing with a big smile on our face.
Okay, we'll be back with more I'll Buy That on the Mike Ditka Show right after this timeout.
The Mike Ditka Show is sponsored in part by American National Bank. We're the bank for business. By Aaron's, the easy choice for tough customers. By Budweiser Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. And by Toyota. See your Toyota dealer.
There's a big difference between a bank with a business department and a bank that's all business. You see, at most banks, you'd hardly notice if the business department were to suddenly disappear. But at American National, it would be rather obvious. Of course, we're not about to disappear. Just making a point. In Chicago, there's only one bank for business, all business, nothing but business. American National.
This Bud's for all that you do.
Say, landscaper. Tomorrow, college student.
Yep. Finally took your advice, Mike.
You taught him.
Already you're smart.
All you knew. They say he's a lot like you. Yeah, you make America work. And this Bud's for you.
Here's to you, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
To a future architect.
And to a brother who made it possible.
This Bud's for you.
Mike, now that you've had a few days to reflect on it, what are your thoughts about the McMahon situation and how the team stands now?
Well, you know, the unfortunate thing is it's a big disappointment for Jim personally because, you know, he's a competitor and he's a great football player and he wants to be a part of a great season. And it's such a weird set of events the way everything came down. I really had a gut feeling a couple weeks ago that he really wouldn't be able to play very much. It'd be very limited if he could play. And I think maybe this is best because at least it lets him know where he stands physically, what he has to do to get back to where he has to get, really. And it's going to take not only surgery, but it's going to take a lot of rehabilitation and then conditioning after that to get the shoulder back where it belongs. He's got a lot of hard work ahead of him.
Do you think now that you say you know how it stands, do you think that this could in a way be a positive effect on the team? Hey, they know that McMahon's not waiting in the wings. And
I think to a degree it will be because I think we just know what we have and we have to go with it. And I think it would be hard to say the defense is going to play any better or the special teams are going to play any better, but I think everybody's going to try a little bit harder and try to give the other quarterbacks the support that they really deserve. And you know, we've been struggling on offense. We've been moving the ball some, but we really haven't been getting points, and it's disappointing. And we have to get some points. We have to take some pressure off our defense because we're expecting them to shut out everybody, and that's just not going to happen. We're going to run into some real good football teams down the line who you're not going to be able to shut out. You're going to have to score with them.
Well, you know what everybody's been saying all year is that, you know, McMahon gets better. The Bears can't win the Super Bowl without McMahon.
Who's everybody? And I never met him.
You never met everybody. Okay, Doug Flutie. What kind of situation are you going to try and get him in?
Well, I'm going to try to play him, not necessarily today, but I'm going to try to play him in the next couple of weeks to get him some experience under fire, whether it be for two series or three series or a quarter or something. I've talked to all the quarterbacks this week, and I explained exactly what my feelings are with each of them, what we expect to do, how they're going to fit into our plans, and I think they're excited. I think it's a tremendous opportunity for every one of our young men to really you know, I don't know what's going to happen. I'm not a script writer. I can't write the scenario how the season's going to go. But stranger things have happened where a young quarterback or a guy like Mike Tomczak. And I really had a dream last year that Mike was going to be the quarterback in the Super Bowl, but it didn't work out because Jim came back and, and was ready to play. But I really thought Mike would be the kid that would be the quarterback in the end.
Okay, let's take a look at some videotape of the offense. When did you first realize that in this game that McMahon wasn't, that he was worse, he wasn't going to make it?
Well, I tell you, first thing I saw, which I never saw last week, was pregame. That's the first time I saw it was in pregame, where the arm started dropping down, and he started going with almost a sidearm motion, and I knew it was going to bother him then. And then there were a couple passes early that, they just went, they didn't have anything on him, and that was very unlike him.
Okay, here comes the infamous hit right here. Charles Martin comes up, the sneak attack of all time, and he was fined. Suspended for two games. Do you think it was enough?
Well,
no. Wait a minute. I asked Mike. Then you can get.
I think the you've got to go with what the commissioner says in this case. This is the stiffest penalty he's ever put on a football player. So I think that he felt it was justified in this case. Of course, I'm sure Jim doesn't, and I don't think a lot of our players do. I just think there's no place for that kind of action in football. And when that occurs, you've got to really analyze the IQ of the individual involved.
Of course, we showed that last play was Walter Payton. He went over 1,000 yards for the 10th time in his career. Horace Gregg, you made some references to the team that they were thugs, and Horace Gregg retaliated and said that you didn't know what you were talking about. What's your reaction?
I have no reaction, John, because you're trying to stir up trouble.
Me stir up trouble? The only trouble
but there is an old saying in life and that I've lived by: if the shoe fits, wear it. If it doesn't fit, then he has nothing to worry about. It fits pretty well up there.
Okay. Jimmy?
Okay, let's see if we can stir something up out here. Anybody? All right, you, sir.
With specialty teams here, I was wondering, I know Lou Barnes could be a very explosive player, but lately, with his inconsistency, I was wondering if you considered putting a Dennis Gentry or returning Keith Orr to go there.
No, I'm considering some other things. I'm going to let Lou go again this week, and we're going to see what happens. He has had some problems. I think Lou is just pressing a little bit and trying to make things happen. He's dropped some balls, which could hurt us. But we're looking at some people. Dennis has been working at catching punts. Keith works at it all the time, so we're in good shape if we make a change. But right now, I don't want to make a change with Lou. I'm going to stick with him a little bit longer.
Do you feel that the penalty against Martin was stern enough, or do you think it could have been a little stronger because it was Jim McMahon that was hit? Because there is no good feelings between them, it seems like.
Well, regardless of who was hit, it's wrong. This game is tough enough to play when you played it as long as John and I have, and you understand that, it's not everything that goes on the field isn't done out of love, believe me. But as long as you keep the element of respect in there to some degree, you shouldn't have too many problems. There's no element of respect, and it's going not only with the Bears and the Packers. It goes on with other teams in the league when people kick people purposely when they're on the ground. There's no sense in it. It doesn't make any sense. These people are all playing the game for a living. It's a good living. They all have families, children, and you're going to take a guy out of a game for no reason. It's stupid.
With Jim McMahon being injured and most likely going to be put on injury reserve, who would you consider activating?
Well, Mike, Jim McMahon is on injury reserve this week. Maurice Douglas has been activated. He's a young man that we had in the preseason. He's a defensive back. We need another special teams player. I always like Maurice, and he dresses real nice, so he'll fit in.
I saw one thing, Mike. He walked into to the Hallis Hall this week with an earring on. He signed his contract, came back downstairs with Jerry Vannesi, and the earring was off. I wonder if that was a condition of his employment.
Must have been divine intervention.
Okay, Mike. Okay, Martin, on his the jersey he had on number one list, on his list was Jim McMahon, number 9. Why is it that Martin was really out? By him having number 9 on his list, I feel that he was out to hurt McMahon from the beginning.
Well, there's no question. He was. If they had a list like that, the quarterback is the key guy. You try to get him out of the game. But I'm not sure. I look at it a little bit different. I don't think the nine stood for McMahon. I think it was just McMartin was trying to show you his IQ.
Okay, now we're going to talk about defense. Let's take a look at the videotape. And, of course, defense has been superb and has really done a great job. Dan Hampton.
Well, you know, John, you saw it again. Dan had one of the best games he's probably ever had, really. He played super, and, you know, we moved him around a little bit. As you saw, that sack came from the Bear defense, or the old 46, whatever you want to call it. He did a great job.
Richard Dent.
Hey, here's another guy who's really turned it on. Richard is playing outstanding right now. You know, if they can continue the next four games at the pace they're going at, they're going to both end up with quite a few sacks.
That hit right there.
Now, he hit the kid on the play similar to that earlier in the game, and he didn't fumble. He hit him just as hard. He hit him here and caught him just right across. He knocked the ball loose when we had to get the ball back. And Dave Duerson has a knack for the football. He's around it more than anybody, and he recovered the fumble.
Hampton had 3.5 sacks, 6 solo tackles, a safety. Here he comes again, number 99, and the old dive.
Well, you know, he's playing super, and I'm glad, you know, Dan is getting some of the recognition that I think he truly earns week after week, but this year it just hasn't come his way.
Well, it's going to start coming his way now, and we'll be back with more Sean Gale in just a moment.
How about Eddie?
He's just a kid.
So was I.
You've worked long and hard to get there. When the time comes, you hope you're ready.
You make America work. This bus for you.
Here's to you. Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bus for you.
To clear a little snow, an Ahrens ST2+2 Compact is your best choice. To clear a little more snow, an Ahrens 5-horse model is your best choice. And to clear even more snow, Ahrens 8-horse Deluxe model is your best choice. In fact, if one of Ahrens 17 two-stage snow throws isn't right for you, you have only one choice. All Ahrens snow throws are on sale now at these Ahrens dealers.
If you run a growing business, it can be hard to get the kind of attention you deserve from your bank. You see, at most banks, the business department is just one of many departments. But there's a big difference between a bank with a business department and a bank that's all business.
Business department, please.
Sir, we're all business.
In Chicago, there's only one bank for business, all business, nothing but business, American National.
Come on over, baby. Real November dealing going on.
Your Toyota dealer sales event is almost history. So don't forget there's not much time to make a great deal and drive home your new 87 Toyota car from stock. Don't forget, you can still deal on every tough Toyota truck, spacious passenger or cargo van. Don't forget, it's the last year sales tax is deductible, so deal now. Save hundreds more dollars. Hurry before November to remember deals become just a memory.
Who could ask for anything more?
See your Toyota dealer now.
Our special guest today is defensive back and the man who blocked that punt in the game last week, Sean Gale. Sean, I'm not going to waste any time on talk to you in a minute, but I want to put up that videotape to see your punt blocks right away so that we can get a good look at it. But you came from the outside there, and you got through slick and clean, and right. you had the right angle, didn't you?
Yes.
What was it? Did the outside man didn't even give you a shoulder?
No. Mm-hmm. I think they had a mistake on their blocking pattern or something, because mm-hmm.
Actually, he went into block Vesey Jackson, which gave me a chance to get free.
And, of course, Dennis Gentry made the touchdown. Now, you almost blocked another one. Tell us what happened on that one. Here it comes. Now, you're going to come up the, from the outside again. Right. Here he comes, number 23.
Yeah, it was the same, I think, block punt we had called on. And they made the same mistake. The only problem this time is that I came at a bad angle, I think, and I really didn't want to hit the punter.
Mm-hmm. And you kind of eased up a little bit because you thought you were going to hit the punter. Do you like being on special teams?
That's the only job available.
Well, you have filled in admirably over the past few years, and now, of course, you're a little bit more in onto the nickel defense. That gives you a little chance to play a little more.
Yeah, it does. It's a good situation for me because, you know, Gary Fenzik, he's been here a long time, and I'm learning a lot from Gary.
Mm-hmm.
And also Dave, he's done a great job. So I really can't complain about being behind these guys. They're just such fine athletes.
You're on the defense. What was this week, what was the mood? You know, you learned about McMahon. Did the defense get together, or did you guys think you have this feeling, hey, we really got to play super special because the offense is having some problems now?
Well, not really. We feel that the offense will take care of themselves. You know, as a defense, we're going to play tough no matter who's at quarterback. Our level of intensity is not going to go up and go down depending on who's playing on offense. Hopefully, we can always keep it going higher and higher.
Now, you're from Ohio State. What happened last week to the Buckeyes?
A minor setback. Next year, Rose will be ours.
Okay. Let's go out into the audience and get some questions for
this
for
gentleman
Sean
in the back
Mike.
Here.
Sean, do you expect to score more points now the offense sputtering a little bit defensively?
Well, hopefully we'll have opportunities to do that. What we want to do is give good field position to the offense through interceptions and turnovers like fumbles. And with our specialty team playing well, that'll help out the offense also, so we don't really feel that we have to come up with touchdowns on defense. That's just a plus.
Sean, what do you think the defense has to do to get better than it is today, if anything?
You don't want much, do you?
that's a tough question. It's hard to say when the defense is playing as well as it is right now. There's not much you can do to improve it. We have had some breakdowns in certain situations, like the touchdown we gave up against Green Bay. We want to eliminate those. Once we do that, I think we'll be playing the defense that we really want to do.
Okay, well, Sean, first I'd like to say that next year the Rose Bowl will be at Northwestern. That's where it's going to happen. But, and seriously...
I don't think he believes you.
Well, I'm somewhat biased, but... Coach, if you had any legal advice for Dan Hampton at this point, what do you think that might be?
Next question. This young man...
Oh, boy. Don't go to Northwestern.
You made him blush, Coach. Mike, which quarterback are you going to get rid of next year?
They came in together, probably.
The one we signed from Northwestern.
Sean, do you think that your performance on special teams will lead to a future starting position?
I think you're asking the wrong person.
Yes. But not necessarily because of special teams. Sean is the captain of the special teams also, and for good reason. And, you know, just because he blocks punts, that's not the key. He also makes tackles and blocks the opposition, and he knows what's going on in all times, and it helps.
I've got a suggestion for Pete Rozelle regarding what should be done to players that make deliberate hits. I think that they should stay out for as long as it takes the player that they hurt to recuperate.
That's pretty good right there. I never thought of that. That's pretty darn good.
Mike, I just want to let you know, being a Dallas Cowboy fan all my life, I'm transplanted here now, and I have to say I followed you all those years, and congratulations, you're doing a heck of a job.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll be back with the Mike Ditka Show right after this timeout.
There's a big difference between a bank with a business department and a bank that's all business. You see, at most banks, you'd hardly notice if the business department were to suddenly disappear. But at American National, it would be rather obvious. Of course, we're not about to disappear. Just making a point. In Chicago, there's only one bank for business, all business, nothing but business. American National.
You could have this single stage tour for around $500. But for even less money, you could have an Aaron's ST 2 Plus 2 and have two-stage power, a larger intake opening, an optional headlight for safer night operation, and Aaron's exclusive 5-year limited warranty. Why settle for a Toro when you can have America's number one rated compact for less? The Aaron's ST 2 Plus 2. Aaron's ST 2 Plus 2. On sale now at these fine Aaron's dealers.
This bud's for all the chew.
Can I help you?
A friend is counting on you.
Need copies by 4:30.
I'll cover it for you.
Not a word.
You keep on coming through, cause you make America work again. This bud's for you.
Here's to you, Beechwood Age, for that clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser.
This bud's for you.
Well, come on over, baby. Real November dealing going on.
Your Toyota dealer sales event is almost history. So don't forget there's not much time to make a great deal and drive home your new 87 Toyota car from stock. Don't forget, you can still deal on every tough Toyota truck, spacious passenger or cargo van. Don't forget, it's the last year sales tax is deductible, so deal now. Save hundreds more dollars. Hurry before November to remember deals become just a memory.
Who could ask for anything more?
See your Toyota dealer now.
Yeah.
Mike, have you decided where you're going to work out yet for the playoffs?
We've talked a little bit with Mr. McCaskey and Jerry, and, you know, there's a lot of options right now. I don't know. You know, we talked to Tampa. That's available. We want to go that far. We're looking into Wake Forest. We're looking into Shawnee again, and we're also looking at the University of Illinois because I think they're going to put the bubble up next week. So, it would be a pretty good deal.
One of those four, then, probably.
Probably, yeah.
Okay, let's go out. Jeannie?
Questions?
Yeah, The defense maintains a very intense level of play. I'd like to address the question to both Coach and Sean. How do you maintain that over such a long season and then into the playoffs? What are the things that you do to maintain that level of intensity?
Well, I think that, practicing from day to day, you tend to realize what you have to do on Sunday. And once we get there on Sunday, the opposition makes it very easy for your intensity level to go that high. Because they're trying to block you, they're trying to make plays on you. Of course, you have to defend yourself. That's the way we look at it. So basically, we just go out there and play our game and have a good time. That's when our intensity level gets the highest, and we have a good time.
I think what Sean's saying is right, because during the week, it's just practice against their own teammates, and it's not the same. Mm-hmm. But I think the other reason that they are able to do it is they have such tremendous pride in the individuals on that team. I think that they're just so proud of what they're trying to accomplish and what they're accomplishing, and I kind of like that, you know. They're just trying to get a little better every week, and that's what it's all about.
Coach, with the inconsistencies of the passing game, would you consider using Anderson or Sanders in a fullback role to provide some explosiveness?
Yes, I am, and we are going to.
This week, so we might see Anderson and Peyton and...
The unfortunate thing, we had some play set up for Neil. Neil's mother is very, very ill, and she's in the last stage of a cancer situation. So he went home for a few days, and he missed most of the offense this week. But Thomas will stand in there, and he's going to do the same thing. We're going to change up a few formations and just give him something.
So we may see Sanders and Peyton in together.
How smart you are.
Oh! This question's for both of you. The defense playing so good this year and had such a great season last year, I was just wondering, how would you compare the two seasons? A lot of, you know, broadcasters saying that the defense is not as good as last year. I was just wondering how you would compare the two.
Well, if you look at statistics, they show that we are playing just as good, if not better, than last year. Yeah, it's the athletes. We have a great collection of athletes that can do so many things. Our linebackers, our defensive linemen, they're premier in the NFL. and I think they can play any defense well.
Okay, Sean, I'm sorry I have to cut you off. Time has already gone on us. The Bears are going to play the Steelers today. Be sure to stay tuned for the NFL today, and then we'll have Bears Extra tomorrow night at 10:30. Chicago Bears go 11-2 today, right?
Yeah! Holiday greetings from Budweiser. The people who bring you Budweiser wish you and yours the very best of everything this holiday season.
To clear a little snow, an Aaron's ST 2 Plus 2 Compact is your best choice. To clear a little more snow, an Aaron's 5-horse model is your best choice. And to clear even more snow, Aaron's 8-horse deluxe model is your best choice. In fact, if one of Aaron's 17 two-stage snow throws isn't right for you, you have only one choice. All Aaron's snow throws are on sale now at these Aaron's dealers.
The Mike Ditka Show was sponsored by Toyota. See your Toyota dealer. By Aaron's, the easy choice for tough customers. By Budweiser, Beechwood Age for that clean, crisp taste. This Bud's for you. And by American National Bank. We're the bank for business. Mike's guests receive a quality Zenith product. Zenith quality TVs, VCRs, and camcorders. Zenith, the quality goes in before the name goes on.